Hello people, in this video let us look at this book, Datta's textbook of gynecology. So this is all about the female reproductive tract. They are not talking about pregnancy and delivery etc, right? This is gynecology. You have a similar book for obstetrics. Let's look inside. Now let us look at the contents of gynecology. So you're looking at the anatomy, then the lymphatic drainage, nerves, blood vessels, etc. You're looking at the development, that is embryology. Then you're looking at congenital malformations. So if you know embryology, you'll be able to understand congenital malformations, vaginal anomalies, uterine anomalies, etc. Then coming to puberty, normal, abnormal, menopause. So we are talking about the female reproductive system, guys. So focus. So we're talking about menstruation, endocrinology, neuroendocrinology, then examination of a gynecological patient, imaging techniques, pelvic infection. So here you should know what PID, then looking at STDs, individual organs, what and all will affect, dysmenorrhea, disorders of menstrual cycle, abnormal uterine bleeding, that is AUB. Under that you get DUB, that is dysfunctional uterine bleeding, displacement of the uterus, retroversion, prolapse, infertility. See, infertility is covered in gynecology. Interesting, right? It's not covered in obstetrics. And then lesions of the vulva, vagina, benign. Then you have malignant, right? Pre-malignant, then malignant. Then they are talking about UTIs. Are they talking about UTIs? Yeah, urinary tract infections, fistulas. What else? Aminorrhoea. This will basically come as primary or secondary. And here they are not covering menopause as such, isn't it? Contraception, guys, a very important topic in India, right? Contraception comes under gynecology, at least for the female part. For men, all the vasectomy etc. will come in the urology. Okay, here we are talking about only the female, right? Then here you have radiotherapy etc. Hormones in gynecology. Guys, are you looking, understanding what are we looking at? We are looking at gynecology textbook. So we are here at almost at the end of the content. So we are looking at gynecological problems that can happen from birth to adolescence. Special topics like hirsutism, galactorrhoea, then operative gynecology. So here what and all will you have an operative? What operations can a gynecologist do? Did they mention? We'll have to go to the chapter and check. Endoscopy. Current topics in gynecology, stem cells, properties of stem cells, embryonic stem cells and regenerative medicine. Something upcoming. Practical gynecology, instruments, sutures, specimens, so it will help you in your spotters, etc. Guys, so we have looked at the contents of this book, B.C. Datta's textbook of gynecology. Now let's look at some random pages and random images. What do you think they are doing here? Uterovesical fold. This is the uterovesical fold. That is the uterus and the bladder. That fold. They are holding it. And then here they are showing you the uterus. Come on, guess what is it? This is the cervix, isn't it? So what has come out here? What have they made here? Can you guess the procedure, guys? Suture has been put here. And what do you think this is? What is this? Okay, so we will give you the answer. This is the vaginal hysterectomy. So they are going through the vagina and doing a hysterectomy. That is, they are removing the uterus, isn't it? If you are not sure, look at this. These are the images. So they are going colporrhaphy. Then they are cutting the peritoneum, is it? Then the peritoneum is cut open. After that, they are doing some clamping and then they are removing the uterus. Okay, so this is hysterectomy and that is vaginally. Okay guys, let us take yet another image from this book and try to understand. So here's the image. Let's see if you can understand what they are trying to depict in this image. So here, what do you have? Is the uterus, is this the cervix, and here's the vagina. So what is this? This is the transverse cervical cardinal ligament. This is the ligament. Then here they are showing you the uterosacral ligament, uterus to sacrum, is it? Uterosacral ligament, cardinal ligament, that is the transverse cervical ligament. What are they showing here? Other things, levator ani, that is here, levator ani. What else are you seeing? So this image is depicting the supports of uterus. Okay, so what happens when there is a prolapse? Look at this. Here you have the stretched ligaments. Nice diagram, right? So you'll very easily understand the supports of the uterus. And look at the levator ani. Is this the levator ani? As such, there are not too many images, guys, but there are tables here, a lot of tables, and there are flowcharts. So just look at this flowchart and see if you can understand what it is. Evaluation of cervical cytology screening. So this may be important for you guys, because if you're you'll take a cervical smear, and then what will you do? What types of cells are you looking at? Normal cells, dyskaryotic cells, inflammatory cells, an unsatisfactory smear. You'll repeat the smear. Okay, so if it is a dyskaryotic cells, mild, moderate, severe. So mild means you'll let them go, you'll repeat after some time. Moderate and severe, you will do colposcopy. Okay, in that case they are taking a biopsy and then they are checking if it is CIN 1 2 3, CIS. Okay, so they are checking how much of invasion is there. Are you able to see? Invasive carcinoma. Here still it is CIN. What is CIN? So they'll follow up, right? After a hysterectomy, is it? Or local ablative methods, excisional methods, hysterectomy, then finally. So here itself they're doing a procedure. I think that's enough, guys. So we have looked at this textbook of gynecology. We have looked at a few topics from this book also. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.